This is Steve Downs, the voice of Master Chief, Sierra 117, and you're listening to Podcast Unlocked, the world's number one Xbox podcast. Now, finish this fight. Master Chief, out.
We are here to break down everything that was shown off right here at IGN Live. I'm Ryan McCaffrey, longtime host of IGN's weekly Xbox show, Podcast Unlocked. And here with me are my Unlocked co-hosts, Destin Legarry, Stella Chung, and Miranda Sanchez.
Bam!
Hello, IGN Live. I'm going to start right here. I've been covering Xbox for a long time. A lot of you have been watching me and us on covering Xbox for a long time. That was the greatest Xbox showcase they've ever done.
It was fire.
The crowd agrees. They nailed it, and there's so much to get to, and we have not enough time. I could do this all day, and I wish I could. Miranda, I'm going to start with you, because the one more thing after Sarah Bond started to wrap us up was the very thing that you hoped and desired for, and I should have been filming her so I could have posted that, but... Miranda, Gears of War, you got it, but not how you thought you were gonna get Gears of War. Talk to me, please.
When it was announced, when I saw like the TV with logos we know from Gears, I just slammed my hands down on the table. I was like, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, everybody who's working near me. But I was like, is that Marcus? Is he a baby? Is that a baby Marcus Phoenix? Whose hand? Is that Dom? Baby Dom? Yeah, I'm down. I'm at first I was a little disappointed and a little worried. I was like, what if they just drop Kate's story? Because I love Kate. I love Kate and Marcus as a duo. Like, obviously the cliffhanger from Gears 5 was like huge and really important. And I'm like, are you guys leaving this behind? And Microsoft put up a post on Xbox Wire kind of going in depth a little bit more on why E-Day and why they chose to go back to this. And it's like, for fans of the mainliners, which very clearly states that this is... in addition to what they do. So Kate's story will continue as far as I've read into this. Which I'm like, yes. Then I was like, I'm not trying to get up because I don't want to disturb camera settings, but it's like, I'm sold. I'm just giving
you
this.
We'll have to wait a number of years longer to find out which branch, the cliffhanger resolution
is
going to be a while.
That means to me that storyline's going to pay off in like a really cool way because I trust them to get that right. So
I mean, the idea of the E-Day prequel has been floated for a long time. I love that they're actually doing it because it means Dom is back.
The
return of our buddy Dom.
Yeah. Okay, I have to ask, who cried?
Cute.
Who cried when Dom? Yeah. I like every time. I'm just like. Anyway.
And
Dom.
I love John DiMaggio back to the forefront as, of course, our fearless leader in Marcus Phoenix.
Baby Phoenix, he's so
it's awesome. Stella, your thoughts on going back to the beginning here with Gears?
I think that's great, especially for new players, right? They're going to be like, ooh, I can enter in now. It's the perfect time. Also, I hope this means they bring back their esports because I want to see some competitive Gears, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's about time. So I'm personally very stoked on so many different levels.
Yeah. Destin, you've been on the ride with the Gears crew, with the Delta Squad for a long time. Were you surprised that it wasn't Gears 6 continuation?
I gotta be honest, I was just losing it while the trailer was going. I was like, it's Gears! They showed it! I was so freaking hyped. This whole showcase was basically Xbox saying, we're gonna do E3. They had reveals from across the industry. Yeah. It was just awesome. And capping it off with that Gears reveal, heck yes. Absolutely love it.
Yeah. We didn't get a year. We don't know when yet, but they've been working on it for a long time. So, I mean, I think it's maybe safe to extrapolate that it won't be next year, because otherwise they probably would have said 2025 like they did for a number of other games. But yeah,
maybe,
26.
Yeah.
If all goes well, hopefully that's going to be the time that we're all playing Gears of War. They brought back the Of War. Of War to come
Yay!
Back for a long time. Thank goodness. There can be two GOW franchises. It doesn't matter. They're both great.
Yeah.
fantastic. So I'm thrilled. I love, and you know, Coalition's going to bring it on Unreal Engine 5.
Oh gosh, it's going to look gorgeous.
It's going to be insane looking.
Yeah.
So that was huge. So a little quick inside baseball for the people watching at home. We had a watch along upstairs in our panel room at this venue, and we were in our editorial area across the way, kind of hiding in a corner, and we could hear the crowd erupting.
Rightfully so.
And the thing that had the most raucous reaction in that entire phenomenal showcase was Perfect Dark.
Yes.
That was the game that everybody was going nuts for, including myself. Now, Destin, I believe you had made that one of your predictions on the way in here was Perfect Dark. So I'm going to start with you. What was your reaction to seeing gameplay of Perfect Dark?
It looks freaking awesome.
Yeah.
It looks exactly like you were talking about parkour elements.
Yes.
They introduced parkour elements. The gameplay looks interesting in that Perfect Dark way where you're using like stealth mechanics. You can go loud when you need to go loud. There's some puzzle mechanics in there. I'm really, really interested to see how this plays out when you have the controller in your hands. But man, what a reveal.
Well, everybody knows how much I love Mirror's Edge.
Yeah.
I'm a massive Mirror's Edge fan.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
There is some Mirror's Edge mixed
Absolutely.
In
oh, yeah.
to Perfect Dark with the first-person parkour. That part made me really happy. I saw some comments from some people online. That little Deus Ex, maybe?
Oh, yeah.
In there?
Well, there is.
Like, I can see a little of that.
Also makes me happy. Stella, tell me, what was your reaction to seeing gameplay of Perfect Dark?
I saw a ton of things I can't repeat on this stage. But I am so excited. It looks really good. Also, the HUD, I want to say it's so not invasive that it really looks so immersive. I love that so much. Also, the fact that it actually looks like you're wearing a visor, right? Because you're a super spy, you're helping, you're getting aided by tech now in this age. It's so good. And I know some people aren't going to focus on like HUD, but it really does impact your gameplay. Mm-hmm. And it looks so minimal. I'm so excited for this.
So, I mean, it's clear after this showcase, in case there was any doubt, Xbox is reclaiming the title of, we have the most cool first-person games on our platform.
Yeah.
Like, Sony might have the third-person thing.
Yeah.
But Xbox has first-person on lock. Miranda, what did you think of Perfect Dark?
I think it looks really cool. Like, I was not really sure what to expect. I've mentioned this a few times. I was a little too young to play it whenever it came out, so I just missed it entirely. And so I was like, I have no expectations for this other than to be impressed because this is supposed to be a quadruple A game, quadruple A studio. And it looks pretty dang cool. Quadruple A? I don't know. But cool. Absolutely. So I think it's going to be a pretty neat one to explore. I love that there's just, as you said, the parkour elements looked awesome. And so I'm interested to see like the hacking elements, like the overlays when you're in the screen. Obviously a little bit scripted there, but I'm excited to see how more of that expands in the future.
Yeah, I was
pretty.
Not expecting, I wasn't expecting to see Perfect Dark at all, let alone a gameplay trailer. So I'm on cloud nine after that trailer. That was phenomenal. So sticking to first person greatness.
Yeah.
Doom the Dark Ages.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
That was so good. It was so good. Miranda, as our resident Gears of War super fan.
Yeah.
Were you thinking Chain Shield as I was? Because that was...
I was like fanning myself. I was like, oh. That and like the shotgun with the skull in it that shoots bones.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, say less. But yeah, no, it looks cool. And a different color palette for Doom too.
Yeah.
And it's cool.
Are you guys hyped to get back into Doom next year?
Yeah.
The game looks so good. That team is so talented.
Mm-hmm.
Doom 2016, Doom Eternal. I have no doubt they're gonna absolutely just crush this. Destin, talk to me about Doom the Dark Ages and your response to it.
Yeah, that was like one of their opening assets too. So like to see that as the first thing, you're like, okay, are they gonna have more stuff? They did. But this just looks awesome. It's exactly what you want from a Doom game. It's got over-the-top violence, all the crazy weapons that we're just remembering from this very short trailer. I cannot wait to get the shotgun and start killing some demons.
Yeah, the unfortunate part of our job is I haven't had a chance to watch any of these trailers more than once.
Right.
So yeah. I want to go back and study the Doom trailer and a lot of these trailers. Mm-hmm. But Stella, you're just now making your way at my insistence on Unlocked through Doom Eternal. What was your reaction as somebody currently playing Doom Eternal to seeing the Dark Ages?
Again, I said a lot of things I can't repeat, but it is so cool. My favorite thing about Doom is the weapons actually feel so heavy, right? Like, you feel just how big of a guy you are as Doom guy, like, using these incredibly heavy weapons. I love it so much. Chain Shield is awesome. Also, I saw us climb into a mech or something, which looks incredible at the end.
Oh, yeah, the mech.
I want to know more about that. There's a mount. You can ride
the mount.
You get a buddy.
Being able to fight like a colossus-sized monster, I'm like, yes, I am all in. I am so excited. Also, I'm happy to see my husband, Doom Guy, again.
I mean, yeah, anybody that's gotten really deep into Doom and Doom Eternal and has read all the lore in the text log things knows that, like, we're going back to the beginning of the Doomslayer's time before he was on ice for thousands of years or whatever until, you'll keep finding all the journals.
Do you think they're going to show Daisy, his little bunny?
We'll see, but they're definitely, we're going back in time here for sure. Doom is going to be very high on my shopping list in 2025. all right. There are five. See, this was this good of a showcase. Everybody's still fired up, as am I. A game I gotta admit, I was not expecting to see today because we did get that teaser last year, but I believe Miranda that called it in the pre-show. Fable.
Oh, Fortnite yeah.
Candy.
I did not expect
that. I was yours. Yeah. Maybe last year I called it, though, but you did. I'm surprised. I was actually surprised that was just baked in the middle. Like, that seemed like an end or a hard beginning.
Yeah.
So I was like, dang, like, that Perfect Dark 2 is like, it's just a solid show.
How insane visually did Fable look when they're going around the town stuff and the out? I mean, so you know, this is running. This is on Forza Tech. That's what they're using for this. So you are going to get the weather effects, the whole, I mean,
yeah.
It's wild what is going on.
I also like that this was giving What We Do in the Shadows vibes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, it really had that just goofy to Cam. Like, yeah, so I'm a hero. I guess we're going on doing something. You know?
And again, I'm going on memory, which is not a good idea. Fable, didn't they say 2025 at the end of that one? Or am I crazy? I can't remember now.
No,
crowd's quiet. So
no, yes,
I
because
wrong.
I made a joke with Sam about
did, yes.
it being the same time as ETA. So it was.
So I think you could pretty much pencil that in for fall 2025. I can't imagine we'd see it before that. Maybe Doom in spring and Fable in the fall would be already a nice year for Xbox. Destin, thoughts on Fable?
I mean, it looks freaking phenomenal. Seeing the interactions between the different characters that your protagonist is talking to, I was like, I cannot wait to see what kind of stories they're going to tell here. Clearly, you brought up What We Do in the Shadows. There's been a lot of references to the style of humor that they're going to be implementing in this particular version of Fable. We had, I don't remember how to say his name from IT Crowd, but in the previous trailer, and they just keep going to those fan favorite actors. Very, very excited about the new Fable.
Do we have some hype for Fable in the crowd out there? I think we do. I mean, I sure do. I love this game, this series. Fable 2 is my favorite so far, but like we were saying in the pre-show, I just can't think of a more talented team to take this on than Playground.
Yeah.
I mean, they don't make nines, they make tens. Those guys make 10 out of 10 video games.
Insane.
And so, you know, Fable is just, it's just gonna be very high on my wish list. So hopefully that means we'll get to play it for the first time and share that with you on IGN at some point next year. But for now, we got some gameplay. So we've got a lot more to discuss from the Xbox Showcase. Right now, we're going to take a quick break. And when we return, we've got more highlights from that amazing Xbox Showcase. Stay tuned for more IGN Live in just a minute. Showcase right here on IGN Live. Let's keep this recap going and talk about another huge one from today. We'll dip into third party for a minute here. Metal Gear Solid Delta.
Yeah.
Looked awesome. That looked awesome. Destin, I know you love this series. I want to go to you first on Metal Gear Delta. This is an Unreal Engine 5 remake of MGS3, Snake Eater. What'd you think?
Yeah, well, they actually showed a lot more of the introductory sequences and how they've remastered them. So we have a few comparisons on IGN that I have done based off the assets that have been released already. So just getting to see these scenes that I've captured like 5 times remastered, it looks so good. And it's really faithful to how the original was, with some interesting mechanics like being able to climb on the rafters. But Snake looks great, right? Yeah, I'm 100% sold on this one. I'm down to see what Konami does with it. Very excited.
Miranda, any love for Snake? You gonna choke some guys out in that game?
I can do that in real life.
Oh, yeah.
I know. I took judo for a while. But I don't know Snake personally. Like, we're not pals yet. But I'm excited to be introduced to him in this when he gets to be in the mud and disguised a lot. that's kind of what I've taken a lot. It's like, oh yeah, do you like disguises? Do you like the mud? That's just what I remember from this. Yeah. But yeah, I'm interested.
Stella, you diving into the mud with Snake on this one?
Well, everyone knows I'm bad at stealth, but I would try it for this. But it's so funny because when he jumped out of the plane, I was like, oh, it's like Tom Cruise doing his own stunts. And he's doing like the survival and everything. The survival aspect is so interesting. He has to find his own guns. He has to find his own food, which I felt so bad when he popped up in front of that deer. I'm like, oh, I'm so sorry.
Your lunch.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. But it looks really interesting. I'm so curious to see how that works out in Metal Gear.
Well, like the camouflage plays a huge part. So seeing him, the mud scene in question, is like really, really interesting because that'll up your camouflage rating and the CQC stuff has changed. I could go on about Metal Gear.
Well, a game I want to go on was one I heard it called out from the crowd earlier, and we'll go back to first party here. I cannot wait. We didn't get a date, interestingly, so we'll see when in 2024. But this year, Indiana Jones and the Great Circle.
Yeah.
That is Machine Games. Those guys have never missed, not once. Even when they were, before they were Machine Games, that group of developers made The Chronicles of Riddick, Escape from Butcher Bay, one of the greatest original Xbox games ever
Phenomenal
made.
Phenomenal game.
Then they leave and start Machine Games, and they do the excellent Wolfenstein games that we've had since. And now, again, the home of awesome first-person games on Xbox, Indiana Jones and the Great Circle, a first-person game. Miranda, how, like, it clearly looks like Machine Games is going to have an awesome story here. There was a lot to chew on in this trailer.
I wanted popcorn to chew on while watching the trailer because it was so cinematic, right? Like, I think they're trying to, and they've said that they're trying to, like, walk the line of having that cinematic enjoyment experience because it is Indie's adventure, but you get to be part of it. So balancing that out. And I think it had exactly the kind of humor and tone to it that I would have expected. And so it was almost like a confirmation check on that. Like, hey, this is exactly what you're probably expecting from the story. And that's a good thing. We do like throwing Nazis off ships, so, and into pits. So that's great.
Stella, how'd you feel about first person whipping?
Amazing. It was, I can't wait to slap
some cool gameplay mechanics
around.
With that. Yeah.
It looks so fun. I can't wait to slap some people around. I am very curious about the platforming and everything because I'm really bad at that. But also the puzzles. I mean, Miranda, we're gonna be doing so much in Guys, just figuring out like all the different puzzles and secrets.
I'm stoked.
So, yeah, I'm really excited.
Destin, Harrison Ford making some money just for his face off of this game, which, great. But Troy Baker is doing a really good job on the VO side for this. Like, it's, right? Don't you think he sounds pretty young Harrison Ford-y in this.
Yeah, he's nailing that Harrison Ford vibe, and this really focused on the storytelling and interactions between the characters and their mannerisms and how the one actor is making fun of, you know, American cartoons. I really like that, and I like how they sort of vilify that character, but also add a little bit of that campy humor in there. It's really feeling like indie. I'm going to be curious how they implement puzzles and gameplay on top of that, the storytelling, and how that all comes together, I'm really still intrigued about.
And again, like, this is a AAA top shelf Indiana Jones game. It's day one on Game Pass.
Like,
I know that's like almost a meme at this point, like a cliche, but you don't even have to do anything. You just download it and you pay that monthly subscription and you're good to go. But man, yeah, I am so pumped. I have probably more confidence that Indiana Jones and the Great Circle is going to be good than anything else. Like, there was a lot that was great, but given Machine Games' track record, there's just nothing. I have less than zero doubt that they're going to knock it out of the park.
And the pitch comes from somebody that loves the franchise and loves Indiana.
Yeah, Todd Howard executive producing this game, too.
Yep.
So that is, they're bringing it in for the home stretch. If I had to guess, just having done this for a long time, I'll bet Gamescom we get a release date trailer. That would be my guess. If they didn't give us that date, they still reaffirmed 2024.
Right, I was gonna say, I mean, there's a lot of games in the showcase that didn't have a date, it's just 2024. So I think it's kind of continuing with the trend we've seen since the pandemic kicked up, with that people, instead of just declaring a release date, they just wait until they're ready to actually announce it and stick with it instead of having to keep pushing stuff back.
Yeah.
So I think that's safe.
Nothing's out until it's out anymore, but I think Gamescom is a pretty safe bet to get a release date trailer for Indiana Jones and the Great Circle. So, a game that has been highly anticipated for, at this point, many years, and we finally got a pretty cool look at it, was Dragon Age the Veilguard.
Yeah,
what a surprise.
That looked great.
It did,
That looked great. I mean, Destin, you're a big BioWare fan. It has been, actually, this year is 10 years since the last Dragon Age, which was, by the way, IGN's 2014 Game of the Year.
Wow.
Sunset Overdrive got robbed that year, by the way. I voted for Sunset Overdrive. Aww. Yeah, I see some support out there for it. But what'd you think, Destin, of Dragon Age? You know, long hiatus, this game it got announced forever ago. It's already had a name change. Mm-hmm. But now we get a pretty good look or a good idea, at least, of just what it is. What'd you think?
Yeah, I'm still intrigued by whatever Dragon Age is going to wind up being, but what I felt was more important was Xbox showcasing this on their stage as opposed to EA doing something separately or with Summer Games Fest.
Yeah.
Because it shows their commitment to the partnerships that they've been working to establish, and to see Dragon Age on their stage, it's a huge win for Microsoft and Xbox. And that wasn't just Dragon Age, there were a bunch of games like that. And it really made the showcase feel special.
Yeah. Now, Miranda, you love your video game relationships, games where you can establish relationships with your characters.
Yeah.
And this seems like, apparently there's going to be a lot of that going on with, with the companions.
Yeah, it's BioWare. We got it.
Yeah, exactly,
we're going to have those romance guys. what I liked about this trailer, too, is that we had so many like quick looks at new characters that are coming. So like we see Varric and other people that we've seen before, but then it's just like, here's a name flash, a very quick look at like almost a taste of their personality before we actually get to know them. So it's like, I'm already plotting who I'm going to romance first. So, you know.
Stella, any thoughts on what we saw from Dragon Age the Veilguard?
Yeah, I loved Inquisition. That was actually my first entry into the Dragon Age games. Yeah. And I loved it so much, and also loved the romance. There's so many good scenes in there. Romance. But I'm really curious to see where the story's going to go, because it left off, especially with the DLC, there were some pretty hard feelings there. So I'm very curious to see how that's going to pan out. But it looks great. I love that the trailer was kind of formatted like it's a heist. Oh, we're getting crew together, you know? So very curious to see what the story beats are.
Yeah, is anybody else pleasantly surprised that that had a 2024 date on it?
Like, yes.
That means in
on
the next
that note,
few
though,
months.
I'm a little bummed we didn't see gameplay because it is a 2024. Like, we still got Perfect Dark gameplay, but we couldn't get Dragon Age gameplay. Like, I'm guessing, well, they're going to do some more stuff later, though, so I'm sure that's when we'll get that, and then hopefully release date soon after, too.
Yeah, suddenly the back half of 2024 is looking pretty packed.
We're going to be really busy.
There's going to be no shortage of video games to play, and hopefully what seems like really, really good video games. There's so much on the list. How about, you know, let's go back to another first-person game and another first-party Xbox game. Avowed was in there. We didn't get a release date for that, which I found a little surprising at this point, but we did get a pretty variety-filled gameplay trailer. Destin, we've talked on Unlocked a lot over, like, that game has... It hasn't always won everybody over, right? We had that initial CG trailer that looked had kind
it gave
of quite an
it gave
scroll.
A certain impression, right?
Yeah.
That initial CG trailer, and then they had the follow-up, which was the more recent reveal. But I'm really intrigued by the story that is teased within every reveal so far. Gameplay is looking like it's starting to come together, and it's coming out this year, so we'll know very soon for sure. But the story is what's going to really win people over, I think, with Avowed.
And Obsidian has an incredible track record with delivering great stories and games. Obsidian, by the way, they're like about an hour and a half south of here, down in Irvine. Anybody from Irvine in the house? We got this, I'm not sure, but... Avowed still on track for 2024. We don't know an exact date yet, so I suspect they're probably trying to get confident about it before they tell us exactly what it's going to be. But another one that you can play on your Xbox and in Game Pass this year. Mm-hmm. That is coming this year. So we've just got a couple minutes left. I want to get through a couple of more games. I'm going to skip down... Again, because this is a game that we got a very cinematic, non-gameplay reveal of it last year's Xbox Showcase, but we got to see some gameplay of South of Midnight.
Yeah, that was awesome!
Yes, from Compulsion Games. The art style on this is stunning. Yeah. The art style is beautiful on this game. Yeah, Stella, what would you think of watching that South of Midnight trailer?
Well, also, the voice acting was great. Everything about it was just so perfectly done. The movement is what really caught my eye. The movement looks so fluid, and I love the different ability effects that you see when she was fighting that one monster. But the movement thing is going to be huge, because I saw her walking, and I was like, oh, great, we're going to have another running simulator, but it's not. You have so many different powers, so I'm really interested to see what exactly her backstory is, what we're doing here. Why we're like in Florida because it's got this giant gator. I'm like, no, I'm good. But yeah, I'm very excited.
Okay. Miranda, thoughts on Avowed now that we've gotten a really, really, or excuse me, South of Midnight, now that we've gotten a proper look at it.
Yeah, I love the catfish friends. Like, I'm very curious to see what other kind of critters that we get from down south and featured in this in like a really cool way and very imaginative too. Like, you kind of feel like the magic of it. And I really liked, as Stella, you were saying with the combat, like, I like the white highlights and it contrasts so nice against like this blight that's obviously starting to infest areas and infect the critters around too, it seems. So I'm curious to see a little bit more of the story as well and see where we go with it. But I'm definitely looking forward to this one. It looks great.
I'm not sure. Go ahead, Destin.
Yes, props to Compulsion, like, love South of Midnight. I really just want to make sure we get time for Expedition 33.
And you're just hijacking the final segment, see. Typical Destin move if you watch Unlocked on a regular basis. Go ahead.
I saw the teleprompter. I'm like, I really have to mention Expedition 33.
Oh, no.
Go for it.
Yeah, so obviously, South of Midnight looks great, but there were a lot of games like that that really subverted expectations, right? And one of them was Expedition 33. And it seems to be like a turn-based RPG. Very, very beautiful looking. Available on Game Pass day one. New IP. So, like, we got a bunch of that, and that's another thing that really had me excited.
Quickly, let's do everybody's game of the show. Everybody's game of the show. No, because I know what you're going to say.
Oh, well, yeah.
Destin, I'll start with you.
Oh, man, putting me on the spot.
I am putting you on the spot because you just hijacked the segment from me. No, I'm kidding.
Perfect Dark.
Yeah.
Perfect Dark, I think, is easily the game of the show.
Solid pick. Yeah. Stella, I see you reviewing your notes, trying to make a decision.
They're all
on your
so
game
good.
Of the show.
You know what? It's Doom.
Doom?
Yeah. Doom. Yeah.
I was torn.
Hell yeah. Yeah. Hell yes.
Yes.
Literally, hell yes. All right, Miranda. Just go ahead and say it.
It's Gears of War Egypt, obviously. But I also liked the, what it's called, Something 33. I also really like that. That seems cool.
For me, I went in probably expecting Doom to be my game of the show, but I have to say, for me, Perfect Dark stole it for me.
Yeah. Yeah.
Perfect Dark stole it for me. What a phenomenal showing. That game is, we know, it's been in development for so long.
Yeah.
Like, it's been through a lot. This, and it is really coming together based on that gameplay trailer. So I'm going with Perfect Dark. This showcase was so great. You could have easily picked 10 games
yeah.
and been right.
Yeah.
There was no real wrong answer to Game of the Show on this phenomenal Xbox showcase.
We didn't even mention Call of Duty.
Well, it, yeah. Yeah, the Call of Duty Direct that felt like yeah. Black Ops yeah. 6 looks great.
Yeah.
Black Ops
yeah.
6 looks awesome this year. Yeah, I'm really stoked to get back into the campaign for Call. I've skipped the last couple Call of Duties, but this one, not going to be skipping this one. Black Ops 6 looking great. So that'll do it, everybody, for our post-show wrap-up of the Xbox Showcase. Thank you all so much, but we're just getting started today here at IGN Live. In just a little bit, I will be back in this chair talking to Xbox boss Phil Spencer for an exclusive interview later on today. We've also got Star Wars Outlaws, X-Defiant, Assassin's Creed Shadows, and a live episode of IGN's Game Scoop podcast. But right now, it's time for the IGN Expo, a brand new showcase packed with tons of awesome game trailers right here on IGN Live. Check it out.
Thank you, everybody.